Oh yeah, the villager breeder has been working quite well. We have, what, 6 villagers in there? Mamma mia, we have quite a few villagers. Hey there, Brewberries, what's up, and welcome to another episode on the hardcore Minecraft world. Today we have a bit of a fun little thing to do. So, firstly, what did we do last episode? Well, we got a spider farm up and running, and we have some experience stuff going. And I have some changes to show you there that we'll take a look at in just a second. But looky, looky here. So we now have wonderful gear. The only stuff that's not complete are the pants and the shoes. But we finally have protection 4, aqua affinity, respiration 3, mending, unbreaking on our helmet. So that's very good. We also have blast protection 4, unbreaking 3, thorns, which is meh, I don't care about thorns that much. But we also have mending on there. So the blast protection is huge. Fire protection 4 on our pantalones, need mending on there. And then we have blast protection, depth strider, feather falling, and unbreaking on our boots. And for any of you who are wondering why not put blast protection on your helmet, having more than 2 pieces of armor with the same type of like protection enchantment becomes redundant. The third one doesn't really do anything. So having a regular protection actually would amp it up. So I did protection 4 just to make it so that we had the most well-rounded, I would feel, protection. So we have some fire protection. If we fall into fire, we're not going to immediately just burn to death. And that this will also help with taking the directed damage, I think, from the lava, but not the fire ticks itself. And then the protection 4 also helps out with any sort of blast protection, because protection 4 is just, I think, a lesser protection, but protects you more well-roundedly. So if you have protection 4 on most everything, then you get a decent protection going. But yeah. So I focused on blast protection because of our creeper experience, and because I have, again, as I've said before, I've seen too many hardcore worlds get deleted because of having a creeper just creepeth on up behind you and blow you up. But last episode, we built this little guy here, this little ruin, and I actually am recording this before the video goes live, which I never work ahead. So this is insane. I actually recorded that video a full week before it went live. So that's insane. I am somehow on top of things. But this is supposed to be a ruin. I don't have any spider webs to be able to put on it, and I'm going to put it on it eventually. Wanted to ask you guys, what would your thoughts be on implementing a data pack that lets me use string into making a cobweb? Dear Lord, those chickens are real loud. Turn the chickens down, that's good. But what would your thoughts be on implementing data packs like that that alter recipes or add recipes that make sense, given that even though this is hardcore, this is very much a building oriented hardcore, and so I would like to be able to make some cobwebs. But if not, if y'all would rather me do it the vanilla way, that's also perfectly fine. I don't really want to add too many data pack stuffs in to this, but that was one that I thought to me makes sense. But that's okay if not. But if we drop down here, this is how you get to the spider farm, and this is the entrance. So we have a nice cave here that leads into a mine shaft. For any of y'all who didn't see this, definitely check out the video. It was a very fun one. Actually, one of my more favored videos. It was shorter than normal, which is actually good. But this is the farm, and I've made some adjustments. So we have these two center room things that shoot off. Before, this was all just flat. It was just barrels and a slightly interesting wall design, and I've changed it up predominantly because I would feel horrible if I AFK'd here and missed some spot in this dark area that could spawn a creeper, a zombie, a skeleton, or something that would eventually make its way down here and kill me if I'm AFKing right here. So I decided, you know what? I do trust myself to have made it so all the places are non-spawnable, but I don't trust myself enough to believe that. So I've made these two little jet outs. So this first one, this is where I AFK. I just kind of wander on into this little room, flip it up, oak trap door so I can see it outside. And so in case there is, for some reason, a zombie or something out there, I can be perfectly safe in here. And so this is just like a little room here that is well lit and perfectly not spawnable. And so that is good. I can just AFK, and I have AFK'd quite a bit, as you can tell by getting all this gear enchanted. We have tons of string, as you can tell. This is how much AFKing I've been doing. Tons of string, tons of eyeballs, and it's good. Now, this little offshoot is just where we go to sleep. So I have this because I don't have any idea as to what time it is outside. I'm gonna put an item frame here to put a clock in so that I can tell what time it is. But because right now I don't know what time it is, having a bed is really nice. So then I can just make it daytime. So when I go out the bubble column here, I don't just get myself face to face with a creeper, because yeah, that would be saddening, because boom, I'd be dead. Now, what is that you see? Well, that is something that we will be taking a look at just here in a bit, because I have a... Yes, indeed, that was an unexpected time lapse on my end. But I decided to do a time lapse of the villager breeder because I wanted to continue with that, make sure we didn't forget to finish that build. It is still not totally finished, but I wanted to kind of run you through some of my ideas as to how we're going to be getting up there naturally and how to kind of lead the village up here. And so what I'm thinking is there's a cave right here, and I'm going to make a pathway. I've already marked it out a little bit here with the path blocks, but I want to make a path that leads up to this cave. And then the path can continue through this cave, and it kind of juts out right here. And so it makes for a nice natural way to get up here, because then this pathway will continue on up. And we eventually, you'll see the build right there, but we eventually get on up. Come on, there we go. And we get up, we go under this little part of the aqueduct, and the pathway continues, goes right here. There's a teeny little bridge to get over where the aqueduct starts, and we are taken to the build. So I decided to do a bit of a homage to the spider farm. And this is more like, this is more of like a blend of the villager style and the old style. So you can tell kind of with the wood logs, like where they've tried to fix it, but they've obviously not done it correctly. And so they're just trying to make it so it's at least a worthy building to be able to be something they can live in. They've even tacked on a little bit of a, I don't even know, a garage or something on the end here. But overall, it's still a pretty crumbly building, and obviously the landscaping stuff I'm still not done with, but the building itself is now fully mob proof, which is great. If we get on top here, you can see fully mob proofed up here, and then if we get on up here, you can see here, this is actually, there is a full ceiling. It's all nice and well lit. This little weird pole thing is supposed to just indicate like almost as if like there was a tower or something. And then the eventually the tower crumbled away and the inner floors were exposed. And so that's almost as if like that area right there is where a floor was. But that's all that's really left. So that's maybe like the third story or something like that. And there used to be like a staircase that led up. Maybe this used to be like a watchtower or something on this mountain. But then now this is all that's really left of it. I like telling, kind of trying to tell like these kind of vague stories with these more destroyed ruins, because then you can kind of like, who knows, maybe this was a lighthouse and for some reason there used to be a sea all the way around here and this building is like excessively old, but probably not. But if we go on in here, you can see the villagers are nice and tidy. I even decorated in here just a little bit, giving some pillars and stuff, some supporting structure, and overall looks very good. This has actually been working wonders as I've been building here. Pretty sure there's like four villagers that are down, locked away, unable to kind of get out of the aqueduct drop zone. Did I close that? Yes, I did. Okay. Very good. Don't want any villagers escaping. And so, yeah, this is the nice new villager breeder. It is now nice and updated and looks good. And I think overall does the job pretty nicely. Now, of course, I'm going to continue working on the landscaping and stuff. And hopefully maybe by the end of the episode, I will be able to showcase kind of the end result of this. If not, we'll do it again at the beginning of the next episode. Who knows? I'm just trying to continue working on old projects to make sure that I don't leave any stones unturned. Don't need that torch there anymore, and let's keep a going. Oh yeah, the villager breeder has been working quite well. We have, what, 6 villagers in there? Mamma mia, we have quite a few villagers. So we need to start finding places for them to live, and that is what we are going to be getting into today. Now on this board, you can see some things that I wanted to do, and these are some good starting points for us to be directing the town's progression towards. But in order to do all of this stuff, we need to do a little bit of planning so we know, one, where some buildings are going to go, or at least general areas of where we're going to be putting, like, the various smiths, where we're going to be putting the butcher and stuff. So they all need to be located in sort of quadrants, I think, or sectors or whatever. And to do that, I think we need to do some town planning. Now, sometimes town planning is not the most exciting thing. So what I would like to also do is, there was one section that was called bridges. And what I would like to do today for the main part of the project is work on this river section. So I've indicated by this grass line here where the river is going to go. Now it's going to chop these piggies right in half. Or I guess thirds, and this is also going to be where the river is. And so we're going to have this river running through our town. And in order for us to do that, one, we need to dig the river through, but then we also need to have a bridge that goes across. And I would like to make a decent sized bridge. It is a decent gap, but it's not going to be anything too crazy. So I would like to do this as kind of the main sort of thing for today. And then also in the midst of that, do a little bit of town planning to kind of configure where I think some of the things should be going. Also figure out some of this stuff like this cliffside area, figure out maybe where this cliff's going to be going. And then really just doing a lot of the behind the scenes stuff. I feel like not everyone does it all the time as to the bigger picture thinking. And I think sometimes it's a really good thing to show on camera because not everybody thinks through their town in this way. And I think sometimes it can be really useful to kind of like take a step back and be like, all right, master plan, what are we doing today? So why don't we go ahead and get on into this river project first. And I think we're going to be digging this out. And then I would like to do a little bit of building, maybe not on camera, but step by step. Instead of doing it in a time lapse. And yeah, then we'll just kind of take it from there. All right, so I've been doing some clearing. I got the river dug and filled in. I really wish there was an easier way to make water be like just filled up like this. But eventually got it. So we have the river connected up and it looks pretty decent, I think. I've also been flattening out this area. I brought all of it up to the same level. Which is one block higher than where the river is. I just think that feels more realistic than having it be like fully like down where the wheat is. I just think that it feels a little more realistic. I think I'm gonna do this sort of wheat thing on the other side as well and kind of have it like encased by some, almost as if they're like cattails or something. I'm going to do probably a little less than this and make it more like a thin line versus this full amount. But overall, I think it looks pretty decent. And you can see here, we've got a little bit of a marker for where the bridge is going to go. Now, I would like to make this bridge in the old style with using the stone bricks. So it's like it's a bit more of an advanced looking bridge with some villager touch to it. And you can see I've got two kind of areas here. They're both 5 wide, so it doesn't necessarily have to match the 3x3 or 5x5 sort of villager look. And so it's going to be just easy, very simple arched bridges, nothing too spectacular. But I did two separate ones with a gap in between because I thought it could be kind of interesting to have maybe some flowers or something on the inside just to make it a little bit more decorated. And so it's going to be, this is, I think, what the arch is going to be. It's just going to be real soft, nothing too particularly crazy, enough that you could easily boat underneath with a small vessel, but nothing too crazy. And I think what I would like to do, I was going to continue planning out this area. I'm going to raise all of this up again, like even all the way around here to probably right about there. Going to raise all of this up to this level. And I have moved the fountain from this square area right here to right here, just a little bit more centered in this area. I actually probably should have moved it just a little bit over this way, but that's okay. I don't really want to work on this side today. I think that this requires a lot more mental thought than I would like to put into it today, honestly. And so I think I'd like to stick over here and more this area right here, working on the bridge, getting that done, and then also figuring out what goes on this side, because I think what's going to go over here is kind of the working area, the worksman quarter or something like that. So I think this is going to get torn down. I think that house is going to get torn down. This we can turn into something on the side here. And then I would also like to maybe put a house or something right here. Maybe not a house, but a villager profession building right here. And so I think firstly, we should kind of mark that out. And so maybe we start it right around here, and the stone bricks are temporary. We're not going to be doing it out of stone bricks, but I think leaving a little bit of room right here it would be good. And then we want to make sure that this is in the villager style in terms of how big it's going to be. So let's see. So that should do it. Just a very, very simple, small little house. And then I want to actually take a moment to look up what the blacksmith house actually is like in a Minecraft village, because we don't have one here, and I would kind of like to emulate that. I think that that could be kind of interesting to first maybe build it up the way it actually is, and then maybe in a couple episodes or something we take a re-look at it and revamp it. Could be kind of cool, I think. So let me do a little research here in a sec, and then I will go ahead and mark it out. All right, got a little bit more planned out. So firstly, you'll be able to come through here, and we'll have a building right here. I'm not sure exactly what, but as we planned that out before, then we're going to have a building right here, which is going to be probably like the alchemy type area where we can do our potion brewing, potion shop or whatever. And so it looks a little big, but it's not actually the main building part, is just these three chunks right here. So not too particularly big, maybe a little bit taller, but nothing too crazy. Still following the 5x5 rule. And then this, I was going to make this section right here actually where the blacksmith is, but I think this could actually end up being the Fletcher maybe, and have a little workstation out here for like leather and all that stuff. So we'll have like a little outdoor area right here. And then the Fletcher can be moved maybe back a little bit, so it gives this road a little bit more room. But for right now, I think this is fine. So the Fletcher will be a moderately decent sized build. And I just realized it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that is this. I will fix the dimensions because it's not correct. It's supposed to be 1, 2, 3, boop, 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 and like that. And so actually that can help solve for the issue here. And we can just kind of work on the shape of the building to be a little bit more interesting, perhaps. Maybe we just do 3, 4, 5, and then do that. Boop, 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 boop. And bada bing, bada boom. What a finished, beautiful product it is. And I will obviously clear all the ground stuff out for now. But this is good for right now. We can even have like a little back porch area. And then for the blacksmith stuff, I was thinking actually, so we're going to have, the road does continue this way, so we'll put something over here. And then what I was thinking is this house, we can just kind of revamp, leave it there. But we have this cliff area here, and because the water needs to be, also look at all the little villagers we have. We'll get you houses, I swear. because I, of the water, this sort of being a little bigger than I was expecting, I need to extend this out. And so I figured might as well just make it a bit of a bigger plateau area up here to add a little like variety in height. So what we're actually going to probably do is lower that area. So this is like a bigger bigger difference in cliff size. Get rid of a lot of this ground area so it's not interfering with this. Like, I don't think this makes sense. And then we'll have the blacksmith area pretty much taking up all of this, because there is the armorer, there's the toolsmith, and there's the weaponsmith, and a fletcher, and then there's also the leather worker. So fletcher and leather worker could be paired together perhaps in that building right there. Or we could just do the fletcher right there, or yeah, it's kind of, there's a lot of individual sort of builds that we need to make to incorporate them, and I think it makes more sense. Oh, and a mason, maybe a mason could go with, I don't know, it's kind of like, there's a whole lot of overlap, and so, and this build also needs to become something, I just don't know what exactly, and I don't really think having cows here makes sense, so perhaps what we do is, maybe we do the fletcher right here, maybe we do the leather worker right there, and then we do the toolsmith and weaponsmith back there, and then maybe this could be the mason. And so then we have a good amount of variety in this area, and then we can kind of tack on some smaller thing there. Perhaps we could do, maybe we could make this into a cartographer's house or something like that, make it a little bit bigger. I think that could be kind of interesting. And then what I would like to do, I think, then is, so this is going to be kind of the trade area, the main trade area. And then I think it could be kind of nice then to make this sort of the smaller market square, if that makes sense. So more of the not actually having villagers associated with it. That's basically what I'm envisioning, is this is going to be the where we get to be creative in making market stalls and kind of like a nice market area. May not even have houses near it, or if anything, they will be very small little shops. And then what we can do then is be a lot more creative in this area, and not have to abide totally by the villager style. And so I think that is a good plan going forward. Now, I would like to tackle this bridge. And so I think the first thing that we should do is lay out more of this sort of arch, just to get an idea as to how it feels with both of them. And then we can start figuring out the underlying structure so that it looks sound and makes sense in our world. Now, I know I originally marked this out with stone, but I think continuing the theme of the diagonal bridge that's over yonder would be a good idea. And what we did for that was we did a variety of woods to make up this sort of structure. And I think that will play very effectively into the sort of rustic style of the villagers as well. And so let's go ahead and throw in some wood here, because I think I love, honestly, this is one of my new favorite things for doing things like this, is intermixing some of the different wood types together, especially something that isn't used that often, birch. I think honestly throwing in just that lighter tone every now and again is actually really, really effective in breaking up even these two middle tones. They're kind of similar, and so I think throwing in this really vibrant part is very nice. All right, floors are in, looking good, and I think I'm gonna actually add some trap doors every now and again to kind of make it feel a little shoddy as well, and I think that'd be good. Don't know what the middle section is going to look like, but we are going to take on this next portion, which I think for this top bit, what we're going to do is we're going to add walls here to make it feel a little bit more protected without feeling like a full block. I think the full block adds a little bit too much. And so maybe having the wall will make it feel a little better. But what I like to do when I'm doing stuff, and then maybe we do a slab here or something, could feel different. I don't think I like that. But what I like to do when I'm making these bridges is I like to go through and get rid of the blocks that you really truly don't need right now. And even for this, I don't think you need the full block. I think you can get away with the slab. And then you start getting this arch feeling. And so then this, if we get on up, now I made it so the only issue with this is I made it so I can't actually get up, but that's okay. We can break it all. This, I think what needs to happen is we need to have slabs here. And then I think we'll do slabs on the bottom side of these because that will make it still look like a full block. But from down here, it now has a nice arch to it. And now that I'm seeing that, I think that this wall thing is not going to work. It needs to be a slab, I think. And after a little bit of playing around with the general dimensions of everything, it is looking, I think, fairly decent when it comes to a sort of bridge style. Now, I do realize that something that may be irking any of you with OCD is that should have been a stair. And now should be fairly even on either side. It is, except for I did an alteration on this side that I wanted to show. So I decided that this arc felt a little too steep. It felt like it needed to kind of gradually get up there a bit more. And so instead of going stair, slab, block, I went stair, slab, stair. And that's what we need to change here. It goes stair, slab, block, and it needs to actually be a stair to a slab. And then this is a stair, stair, and a block. And I think that looks like a better, more gradual arc. And I think that will look good. Yeah, I think that's good. And so now it comes the making of the other entire sides of the bridge. All right, and after a little bit of work, we now have two semi-complete bridges. Now, I need to make some texture variation in it, I think, to make it more interesting. And I may do some experimentation with if there's like going to be a covering or if we're going to do some stuff on the sides. I think doing stuff on the sides sounds more interesting to me because we already made a covered bridge and don't need to necessarily make another one. So let's make it a little more interesting via the sides by doing like planter boxes or something, adding more depth. That's, I think, the issue is it's very flat. And I think also for the texture variation, we're just going to do the cracked stone, mossy stone, and regular stone just to keep in with the theme of what we're going to be doing to this. Eventually, we need to do like a time lapse or something of just texture variation on this because I think I'm going to hold off doing this because building it without feather falling, we have feather falling now, so I'm very happy about that. But building it without elytra is a little sketch as well because I still think that this height is far enough for us to take some pretty serious damage. And if it were to be combined with a mob area or something like that, I just don't want to deal with that. I don't want to die and lose this world because we were building something tall. And so I think the next step to being able to complete the texture variation on that is to actually build the potion shop because then we can make slow falling potions. And I actually want to make a good amount of those so that we can use them in when building really tall things so we can kind of just float our way down. And I think that's kind of a fun, unique way of handling hardcore and building really tall things. All right, so I have all the texture variation done, and now what I'd like to do is tackle those outer decoration bits. As you can see, nicely decorated out with our color palette, block palette, whatever you want to say. I actually forgot to show you, I did this underneath part as well. I think this looks very nice. You've got the archways. I forgot to do the slabs there, so I will get that fixed. But you have nice archways here. And it looks very much like supporting structure as if the bridge actually goes further down, which helps sell the bridge better, I think. But what I would like to do is maybe add some interest right there. I think that could be interesting to do. I think maybe what we do is we have some trap doors on the sides. Think that'll look good. Maybe what we do is we get rid of this and then add in we'll just go with the stone brick and add a stair here like so. So then when we add a slab, it doesn't look too particularly not supported. I don't know how I feel about that. We'll give it a moment to sink in, and then let's add some bushes and stuff up on top. We'll do that. Bush, bush. How do we like that? Does that add anything or does it detract? Yeah, I think that actually adds a lot. I think that looks very cool. So I think what we could do for this middle section is similar to what we did there and make it so it's like roughly here. But I think I honestly want to bring it down like so and make it so that it kind of just goes the entire way. And so we'll have like flowers and stuff the entire length of the bridge to kind of like connect them up. I think that could look interesting, especially if like we block this off so it looks like it's a nice potted area. Block this as well. And then I thought, what if we did sugarcane? How does that look? Because we could have that. And then may we do like a leaf over it, and you would never really know. Like you just truly wouldn't ever know. And then we could do maybe a leaf there and then do water like that. Do that. And then perhaps we could do that. How does that look? Okay, I think we're going a little overboard, but at the center, I don't think that that is a bad call because it's kind of interesting. I think it looks pretty cool. So we could do that there, and then here is where we could do potentially, I think, honestly, the rows would go really well here. So let's get the bone meal again. Get one rose, and then how do we do that? So we did rose, and then the bush, and then I think there we could do the azure bluet, or we could do another one. But I like that. I think that looks really nice. The sugarcane adds just like a unique kind of color palette flair, and I think that looks very good. Let's grab the peony and put that back. Now I kind of want to put roses over here. Let's go ahead and put more roses around and see how we like that. All right, and with a little bit more path making, we are starting to really feel what this is supposed to feel like. So we'll be able to come through here, and you'll kind of like, I would imagine that's kind of like the like an entrance that would kind of unveil the town, because the town will be spread up here as well, so we'll definitely feel it from up above. But this will be kind of like your main way of getting over to the town, and I don't really want any way besides, I guess, the deck area of that house to get up there until you get around to here. And so you kind of enter through here, and I like the look of that bridge. I think it looks good. I really, really like it. It's just small and easy to build. It's nothing too particularly crazy to build, and it looks good. And so then you kind of come through here. We'll have our different shops and stuff, and ooh, I like it. I think this is looking good. Maybe we'll set up like a little market right here, or like a little stall or something, or a stall right here. I think that could look really cool. A little stall here, a little stall there. Just you kind of enter in and you kind of get enveloped. Of course, we need trees, and we're going to be adding more of those trees around. But look at this. It is so, so nice. It ended up just going with rose bushes because I think that looks good. This area is a bit of a mess, but we will figure it out. Eventually, it'll all be on the same level. Maybe what we could do is have this be all on the same level, and then the market area, this area kind of like dips down by one block. That could be interesting. Just add a little bit of interest, like a little tiny dip in the land to make the market stand out a little bit. That could be good. Boy, they're having a party in there. Oh, yeah. I don't know what type of music you're listening to, but it seems it's going to be in the rave category. But guys, I think that is going to have to do it for this episode. I know we didn't do an astronomical amount of stuff today, and it was maybe a little bit low-key of an episode, but some of the plans needed to be laid out. I needed to do some thinking, and I thought maybe sharing that a little bit on camera would be good. Because I know sometimes the planning portion can be kind of the tricky part of making a town. And so, I mean, look at this view. This is wonderful. I love how the bridge blends right in with the sort of aqueduct. I think that looks really cool. And I'm pleased with the direction that this town is going. Still have tons and tons to do, of course, but I'm very happy. Also, that little area up there is looking pretty good. I like it. I think it looks a little funny, but I think that is kind of the theme behind it. And so if you guys like the video, leave a like in real life. If you like this bridge design and would like to see a little bit more of a step-by-step tutorial, I could try and put that together. I tried to do that a little bit in this episode just to give you a little bit of inkling as to how I went about doing it. But if you want to see a little bit more in depth, definitely just let me know and I could go ahead and do that as a short little video or something. And yeah, if you like the video, leave a like in real life. And if you're new here, feel free, subscribe. Wow, I hit the Zoom key. Sorry about that. But feel free, subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Bye-bye.